of peace that the world cannot give. It's a peace that the world cannot understand. Peace to know, peace to live. My peace I give.
going to say. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the last day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, when I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear shall live. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort, who comforted us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble, by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. To our presiding bishop, Reverend Henry Webster, our moderator, Minister Rosa Grignion, other ministers on the platform and in the congregation, greetings. This morning we are here in a celebratory mood as we celebrate the life of our beloved sister and friend, certainly the daughter, she's aunt, Amen. We are extremely happy that the Lord make it possible for all of us from far and near to come this morning as we honor and celebrate the life of Sister Nadine Streete. We want to do this in honor to God. It means, therefore, we are here to worship. And we will worship in spirit and in truth. We will be having the praise and worship. And after the praise and worship, to take us through this program today is our Minister Rosa Grignion. At this time, I will invite the praise and worship team to come forward.
Shall we praise the Lord? Shall we praise the Lord? Word of God says everything we must do thanks. We're going to give him some praise in the house this morning in spite of.
You alone is worthy to worship and adore. The Lamb of God, victorious, unappeased and glorious.
Jesus.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Bishop Hunter Webster, General Overseer of the Assemblies of Holiness Churches in Jamaica. Our Assistant Bishop and Conference Overseer, Reverend Hale. Reverend Noel Murray, General Secretary of the Assemblies of Holiness. Members of the Board of Management of Assemblies of Holiness Churches. Other colleague ministers on the platform and in the audience, all members of the clergy, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, members of the bereaved family, members of the diaspora communities across the region, in the US and in the Caribbean. Ladies and gentlemen, all, very good morning to you. Whether you're gathered with us in the physical space this morning, or you're joining us in virtual space, accept warm Christian greetings. And before we get into our continued service, I just want to pause to instruct as it relates to the restroom facilities for those of you who may need it. It's along that corridor to the back. And I'm going to ask that since we're in a worship session this morning, that unless you are on call, as in you work with the emergency services, could I just kindly ask you to put your cell phones on silence, so they don't disturb us. Thank you much. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, for they rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. Brothers and sisters, friends, we gather here this morning to celebrate the life of one indomitable spirit, a warrior in the faith, Sister Nadine Andrea Streete, affectionately called Precious. She was a nurturing and admirable administrator who was dedicated to duty with an indomitable spirit and a never-ending enthusiasm and passion for the work of the Lord that no pain or illness could dampen. Nadine, my friend, you stayed for what seemed like only a moment. But what an imprint your footprints have left on our hearts. It was Ernest Hemingway who said, every man's life ends the same way. It is only the details of how he or she lived, and how, in this case, she died, that distinguish one man from another. So I say to each of us this morning, life is a song, sing it. Life is a game, play it. Life is a challenge, meet it. Life is a dream, realize it. Life is a sacrifice, offer it. Life is love, enjoy it. We grieve not as those who have no hope this morning. But while we grieve, we are cognizant of the fact that death is only a transition and we meet on the other side. I invite us everywhere to stand and join with me as we blend our voices to sing this great hymn of the church, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Great is Thy faithfulness, O my God.
we quiet our hearts at this time as we invite Bishop Conte Webster to do the prayer of thanksgiving.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Because you are a spirit. Yeah.
in spirit and in truth. We come to you this morning because your words declare that it has been appointed unto man to die. Yes, once to die. Whether we are politicians, whether we are pastors, it doesn't matter our nationality. God, we will pass this way. Then, oh my God, prepare our soul for that great day. Oh, that thou dost wash us today in your precious blood. Take our guilt away. We thank you for lending to us, Sister Nadine. God, we thank you for lending her to us.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
We thank you that she has lived her life to please you. God, she was not perfect, but she was moving on to perfection. Was committed, dedicated. God, she was passionate about the ministry. She has lived an indelible mark upon the landscape of this nation and upon the assemblies of holiness, and we give you thanks for her life. Are in your hands. You have chosen to take her back from her mother, her siblings, her father, relatives, and from us as a board of management, executive council, the wide extended body. You have chosen to take her such a time as this. She has run her leg of the race. Oh God, her level of commitment and dedication, even when she was not feeling well, she was passionate about the work and the ministry. It was her desire to see souls being won for the kingdom of God. As she serves in the missions department, we thank you for her life, work, and her worth. Lord, we thank you for the songs that have sung already. Our hearts have been blessed. We thank you for remaining in service today. The tributes, Lord, that shall be done. Your man servant that shall bring forth your word. We pray fresh anointing. Holy Ghost of God. We pray that every soul will be subject unto your Holy Spirit right now. So we come against every spirit of destruction and spirit of confusion. We bind today, and we ask that your name will be glorified in this place. We pray that every man, every woman, every boy, every girl will receive a word out of the word today. Speak to us, Daddy Jesus. Cause that our ear gates, our spiritual antennas will be up to thee. That you will speak to us. We pray comfort in the midst of grief. Especially for Sister Nam and her children. Undergird them at this time. Father, we thank you that somebody will get saved today. We thank you that backsliders will come home. We thank you for those who are living on the fence will make deliver this vision today. We thank you in advance. We thank you. We thank you, sovereign God. We thank you that even though your people's body goes maybe aching, that they will receive healing in the name of Jesus. We praise you for what you have done already, and for what you are doing even now, and for what you are about to do. We give you thanks in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Blessed Holy Spirit, and the people of God say,
Amen. From Elaine Tapper, and then the remembrance of the Clifton Assemblies of Holiness, in that order. So calling Shalom Street and Dunning Shaw to read the first lesson, and we follow that order. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Not that I want to remind our dear sister now, but this sister is now buried her third child, and that is a very, very hard pill to swallow for any parent, all parents for that matter, to be burying their own child or children. Today, we gather to celebrate our loved one, Nadine Streete, precious. Let us raise up her joyful spirit in the name of love and glory, and allow the holy angels to carry this blessed child of God to her heavenly home, a place that God, her heavenly Father, has prepared for her. Losing a daughter, sister, aunt, cousin, and friend like Nadine, precious, has left great sadness in my heart, all of our hearts. However, as each day goes by, we all hope to find ourselves one step closer to a place of gentle peace and warm, never to be forgotten memories. Therefore, may we be comforted by the thought that the angels will be smiling forever because our loved ones have made it home. God bless her soul as she rests in peace.
Amen.
Let me hear the church praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let me hear the church worship the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are here to celebrate a life well lived for Christ. Remember, this is from the Pentecostal Assemblies of Holiness Church. As you remember our late sister Nadine Streete, affectionately called Precious. Like sand through the hourglass, so are the days of our lives. It's not about the years within our life, but it's about the life within those years. Every day, the cruel icy fingers of death snatch loved ones from our bosom, imprison them in its dark dungeon. This monster death is indifferent to our plea, unmoved by our cry, and untouched by our tears. So since we can neither delay death nor destroy him, we must learn how to cope with him. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. God gives life, and he takes it away. There's indeed a time on earth to be born, and a time to die. And there's indeed a time to laugh, and a time to mourn. There's a time on earth for every season. Sister Nadine Streete had been a member of the Clifton Assemblies of Holiness Church ever since she was young. She migrated to Kingston and came back to Clifton in the prime of her life, where she was given the right hand of fellowship almost a decade ago and was received in the Clifton Assemblies of Holiness under the leadership of Reverend Garvin McHale. Sister Nadine was a worker for God. She gave herself. She gave her time. She gave her resources to Kingdom Building. Sister Nadine can be considered to be a member of all the departments of the church, even the men's department. How she do it? Only God knows. She served Assemblies of Holiness at the local level, the conference level, and the national level. At the local level, she served diligently as Women's Missionary President. She served as Missions Director. She served as Board Member. She was the Rally Trip Coordinator. She knows how to get suitable speakers. When the church wants a speaker, she said, let me know who to contact. She knows the right songs for item. Whenever we want to practice, she knows the right songs for item. Sister Nadine was always at practice, regardless of the department, to give her support. She assisted greatly and gave attention and assistance to the Sunday School, Youth and Men's Department. Sister Nadine assisted the church with filing of the taxes. She assisted the church with the church's report. She created all the WhatsApp groups within the church. She was the person who also created the National Mission and Evangelism WhatsApp group. She said that he was the person who spearheaded, was her brainchild, for live services to be streamed from different assemblies of Holiness Church. She was the person who sourced the internet providers, and she said that he went into her pocket and contributed towards the payment. On Sunday, Sister Nadine would be seen on her gadget, monitoring the online services to ensure that they flow in a smooth manner. Sister Nadine, through the women's ministry, spearheaded a health fair at Clifton. Oh, what a successful health fair it was. It was well promoted, and an article came out in the paper. A Texas team came and visited us at church, and Sister Nadine was one of the persons who ensured that they were okay, and she ensured that all the programs were well coordinated. Sister Nadine is a go-to person. Anything you want at church, you go to her. If you want to know how to arrange a speech and what to come first and all like that, you go to her. She was so, so knowledgeable about almost everything. Sister Nadine was like her personal directory. When we want a number, are we not sure? You know, Reverend XX number and all of that. Sister Nadine, the Nadine said, all right. She has the number, and Sister Nadine will have the number on her phone. She said, hold on, that's some call about, I'm going to get it for you. Sister Nadine initiated an individual and a red carpet service at our church where our pastor was appreciated. And she was the person who ensured that her pastor and family walked along red carpet for the appreciation service. Jamaica Day was one of the major activities of the women's ministry. And Sister Nadine ensured that Jamaica Day was always celebrated in fine style. Sister Nadine does not settle for mediocrity. She always does things in an extraordinary manner with all her endeavor. She knows how to get things done. Sister Nadine knew how to get Joan Fleming to come to Clifton for a Jamaica Day. She also knew how to get our pastor Reverend Garvin McHale on national TV. For one Jamaica Day, Sister Nadine was hospitalized, and she planned and organized Jamaica Day from the confines of her hospital day. Sister Nadine was not well, but she did not allow this to hamper her service to God. It's as if her illness pushes her to do even more for God. She gave up herself 100+%. She worked very hard for the church. Sometimes we say, sit down, gracious, precious Savior. I can sit down. We say, sit down, precious, precious, we say, I can sit down. Sit down, precious, precious Savior. I can sit down. I'm here on a mission and I just can't sit down. I can't sit down. I remember Sister Nadine saying that she belongs to God and is completely sold out to Him. So she made a promise to give God every second, every minute, every day, every week, every month, and every year. Sister Nadine does nothing but church work. We know her anymore. Sister Nadine, in the morning it's church work, afternoon church work, dinner time she has to fold doing something for church. We hours of the morning, Sister Nadine was all church work. Church was Sister Nadine's life. The last time most of us saw Sister Nadine was the last Sunday of December, the last day of December, that was New Year's service. And she was also at Watch Night service. We surprised a lot of persons. When persons saw her coming, they said, Sister Nadine coming out in the hours of the night, and we know that she was not feeling so well. But Sister Nadine came out to watch night service because she knew she was on a mission for the King, and her eyes were fixed on the prize. Sister Nadine was being prepared for the new world. In that new world, there will be no more suffering. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf shall be unstopped, and the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with songs and everlasting joy upon their heads. We are happy that Sister Nadine did not put her all hope in this world. She knew she was just passing through, so she was preparing, being prepared for the new world. To hear her voice, to see her smile, will be our deepest wish today. But her precious memories will linger forever and will never be erased from our hearts. She will be sadly missed by the pastor, members, and visiting friends of the Christian Assemblies of Holiness Church. Sleep on, Sister Nadine. Sleep and take your rest. May her soul rest.
She has left campus. And I can testify to what Sister Pam read. Because I traveled with her for the last 3 years to all national board meetings and other events. And many times when she called the night before to say, "Sister, friend, what time are we leaving in the morning?" And I would know that she's in pain and cannot manage a journey. And I said, "Girl, stay in your bed and I'll carry you today." She said, "You don't understand. But not left me." And she sat in those meetings sometimes groaning behind me in pain. But she said, "Not left me." I wish that we would be as committed to the work of the Lord and keep our promises to God like she did. Thank you, Sister Pam. Thank you, Miss Tapper, Miss Wisdom, Uncle Colin, and Danique and Shanova. We move on, ladies and gentlemen. I now invite Jazelle Foster Brown, the niece, to come and do the second lesson for us. It comes to us from Psalm 90, verse 4 to 6, and verses 10 and 12. Right after that, I'm going to ask Marjorie, my cousin, to read the tribute from Bishop John Ivan Klein. And after that, Deaconess Moyna to come and read the tribute from Sister Anne-Marie Vidal-Corey. And then that will be followed by the tribute from Minister Gregory Walker to be read by Norman Dubida, in that order. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Our second lesson comes from Psalms 90, verses 4 to 6, 10 and 12. "For 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as asleep. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withereth." Verse 10. "The days of our years are 80 years and 10. And if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow. For it is soon cut off, and we fly away." Verse 12. "So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom." Here ended the reading of God's word. We honor it by saying, "Thanks be to God."
Amen. Happy Sabbath, everyone. Tribute from Bishop John Ivan Klein. "Nadine, I met while she lived and worked in the British Virgin Islands, and she became a one
wonderful friend from that time on. Her spirit was one that was infused with a love for God and people. Nadine, I held dear to my heart, though distance separated us. I loved her dearly. She's gone too soon and will truly be missed by me and I'm sure many others. I thank God for her life and will forever cherish the memories we shared. She now rests from her labor here on earth. My condolences to the family, and may God bless you all.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, good afternoon. Tribute to the very precious people, Nadine Streete, by Anne-Marie Banner Quarry. The name Precious is very popular in many cultures around the world. Nadine is of French origin, which means hope. The name also has roots in German and Arabic languages. In German, it means tender or delicate, while in Arabic, it means dew, shower of blessings. People with this name are known for their creativity, sensitivity, and are independent thinkers who value their freedom and autonomy. Nadine and I were childhood friends. We attended Clifton All Age together and spent a lot of time bonding in her earlier years. I was saddened when she migrated to Kingston to join her mother. However, we would connect with each other occasionally whenever she visited her dad. Nadine returned to Clifton a few years ago, and we just picked up where we left off from childhood. She had a sense of humor, and she was kind. We had plenty debates on some difficult matters, and it was not easy to win. She was strong-headed and held firmly to her point of view. Nadine has a passion to serve in the various leadership capacity. However, missions and evangelism had her energized. She was a go-getter, and whatever she set her mind on, she would go in pursuit of it. She cared about people. She found ways to tap into resources to help the less fortunate and the shut-ins. She used her platform to honor those who served in the various departments in the church. The next big adventure she was planning was to honor Reverend Cunningham for her service to Clifton, especially in the prayer group ministry. There are a lot I could say, but this will sum it up, as she used a poem to describe Nadine. N, neat, network. She knows how to connect people and communities to resources. A, autonomous, ambitious, attentive to details, assertive in her duties. D, dreamer, dreaming about the next event, activity, even before completing current. I, impulsive, independent, inspiring, inquisitive. N, navigating challenges, never succumbing to defeat. E, energetic, eloquent, empathetic. Rest well, my baby girl. Rest well, my friend, Lady Anne and Mary. The Lord bless you. Yes.
Good afternoon, family and friends. I'm reading this tribute on behalf of Minister Brenda Walker, who unfortunately could not be here today. Beyond the valley of sadness lies the comfort of grace. Sister Nadine Streete was a dedicated, sincere, devoted servant of God. She gave her time of service to the Lord, executing her assignments faithfully. She will be missed in that capacity. Now that God has released her from duty, she can say, I am free. Don't grieve for me now. I'm free. I'm following the path God laid out for me. I took his hand when I heard him call, and I turned my back and left it off. I could not stay another day to love, to work, or play. Past left undone, but stay that today. I found peace at the close of day, with sympathy to the family more than ever. It means so much that you can be there for each other and draw strength from the love that you share. To the church family, the words fall short at a time like this. Please know that as you all be thought of with the deepest sympathy for your loss, may the presence of God shine bright around you. With the love of God, keep faith alive. God bless you.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, let's just change the pace a bit. I'm going to invite the Great Valley Assemblies of Holiness to come at this time with their selection. And that will be followed by the tribute from Crystal Jones, missionary Crystal Jones, to be read by Deaconess Alicia McHale. Then the tribute from Nancy McLean, manager. I'm not sure if it's ready, Christy, who's to read that. That will be followed by the tribute from the Board of Management, Assemblies of Holiness. And then the tribute from Reverend Donald McFarlane, Bishop of the New Foundation Christian Ministries. In that order, let's welcome the Great Valley Assemblies of Holiness.
Hallelujah. We praise the Lord. We praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
High upon the mountain, from where he ascended, an angel of the Lord descended to me. He said, "Rose, stand there breathing, for the one that you see me
truth characterizing Sister Nadine. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. St. Matthew 5 and verse 4. And nurture. Nadine cared for and nurtured the growth and development of her family and church members, and many other individuals she encountered as she served as a missionary. While I was a guest in their home, Nadine and her mother, Sister Norm, nurtured me and made sure I had my meals and made sure I feel like I was at home in their home. Here I was in a strange place and the people I just met. And by the time the mission trip was over, I didn't want to leave my new family. Praise you, Jesus. A. Admirable. Nadine's service for God and His kingdom is truly noteworthy. She rendered support to our mission team in 2019 when we came to teach vacation Bible school and to conduct evangelism workshop. Nadine believed in doing what she could, while she could, as she battled her health challenges. Be diligent. Nadine was a diligent servant of God, even when she didn't feel well. When I received the event flyers and invitation from the church, I knew Nadine had a hand in putting the event together. Because of the way the communication was shared, the program agenda and event details were on point, always well done and based on God's words. Insightful. Nadine had a deep understanding of what was expected of her. When it came to her service for God's kingdom, she was always invited, always willing to share. Even with their mother, with me and others, she was analytical about how she could get information to the masses so they could hear about Jesus. And she worked until she got the job done. Nice. Nadine was nice, pleasant, and respectable towards me and the members of the mission team. And I just knew she... exuded these same vibes towards her family and Clifton community. She was a good neighbor who always put others before herself. Praise God for her spirit. E. Encourage her. Nadine let her words and her deeds speak for her. She always spoke words of healing and comfort to me. Probably you too. During a time when the world needed both, Nadine did her part to lift up all who cost her part and to help those who were weak. May we all be encouraged to do the same. Rest in peace.
Photographs of her at the Pegasus
And when she worked for Keith Brown, she was indeed surprised. Nadine never hesitated when I asked her to join my team to do wedding expos, food festivals, and other events. Nadine was quite detailed and thorough. She knew her work ethics. She would dedicate herself to whatever task she had to do. When I was at the Lady Club, Nadine was my right hand and always telling me to take it easy. I knew she wasn't well, and I was always concerned about her welfare. Nadine became very concerned about her mother and wanted to go home where she could take care of her. After Nadine moved home, I heard from her less, but every now and then she would make contact. When I learned of Nadine's passing, I was really sad, but no more suffering, and I know she is at peace, as she was quite a religious person. Rest in peace, my dear friend Nadine. Rest in peace.
She became as you heard earlier, the planner for everything that you've done. She came to prominence in the Assemblies of Holiness when she was sent as a delegate to the annual general meeting by the church to represent them. An extraordinary delegate she was. One who engaged the general meeting, anybody who knows her, she's not afraid to ask questions. She, anybody goes to give a report, they'll be prepared to listen and hear what Nadine has to say or have to ask. Because she doesn't understand, she's going to ask. And going to have an answer for her. She had relevant questions. And where she finds that is lacking, she has recommendations. It was so surprising. It was so surprising to when we it was noted in the it was no surprise for her when she was elected in 2018. No surprise to anyone. To be national director, because everybody knows what everybody could do. And then in the same year, the same meeting, she was elected to the board of management. So both offices were held by her up to the time of her passing. Frankly, I personally look forward to work with her in this year. Meeting just gone like 2 weeks ago. And I look forward to working with her because we had a conversation, a very pertinent conversation in December. And she was looking at the very same street up which I was looking at. No wonder why I came to the street, looking in the same direction. And some ideas I had, she had the very same ideas. And personally, I was looking to work with her, but it was going to be. Sister Nadine, from the onset of her national appointment, had been very sick. She was ill and we all knew that. She had a number of complaints, but you never hear a complaint. I heard Mr. Greenland talk about her going to meetings. And sometimes when she comes, she might go in the car and sit down for a while. But she's not going to let one meeting pass. And she's not present. Very seldom we have an apology for somebody whom we knew was very young. She will never cease to carry what has never ceased to carry the mandate that was given to her. In spite of severe pain, she was always working. Discomfort, yes, she knows what it is. Most times, you'll see her grimacing in pain, but you'll never hear her say, I am feeling pain. Never. And she also had challenges walking, and she prefer walk without pain, but she's going anyway. No one could tell her that she was sick, because Nadine is always smiling. Has a smile on her face all the time. She pushed herself beyond call of duty to reach goals. She won't do anything because she liked to reach her goals. That's Nadine. And consistently, she attended all board meetings, as I said earlier. She had what I call a resilient spirit. And her tenacity as an event planner and fundraiser ignite and focus the mission department of the Assemblies of Holiness to the biblical mandate of all of us. We see pictures of her attending National Prayer Retreat, and Reverend Parkins, who is the head of that, is here and can attest to that, in August of 2022. And it was known, in fact, that she was very ill, but she was adamant that she would be at the fire retreat. We can still recall a successful online evangelistic crusade that she and her team conceptualized and executed in 2021. I know what that year was. It was in the height of COVID. She had live streamed international worship group out of Tortola and was streamed live on YouTube in the heart of a pandemic such as that we faced. And in the face of those who thought it wasn't a viable option, and we weren't virtually ready for that kind of thing some people were saying, but now you prove everybody wrong. When faced with opposition to carry out the mission project that she is convinced God had laid on her heart, she would say, even if I had to middle manage this activity, I will get it done. What she means is she has said, you're not tasking, you're not taking the country to be done also. That's not it. Because it's going to be done. When faced with opposition, Nadine does not allow anybody to think that she doesn't have the tolerance, because she's going to tolerate anything, because she knows that what she's going to do is going to happen. We see also how she successfully planned and executed the national fundraising rally in Southwestern Conference. And I've been overseer, I can tell you, because she and I work together. And when she came up with some challenges, she called me, she said, well, what are we going to do? I said, what is the problem they have with her? And she started telling me. I said, Nadine, I know you, and you and I can do it now. She created history herself with her fundraising. It is something that was thought of but never done. A national fundraising activity. And she said, we're going to have a national rally, and every church is going to participate. Some people were saying, come from so far to participate, travel all the way to Westmoreland, and then he said, it's going to be done. And I was the overseer. And I am still the overseer. And we worked, and that night, the turnout was awesome. The participation was awesome because Nadine left no stone unturned to make it happen, and it did happen. I tell you, this woman, there's nothing left that we can think of Nadine that's good that, even though we're not back, might not be able to say that, but this organization, the Assembly of Holiness, has lost a hard working, stalwart in God's kingdom. She epitomized Lydia in Acts. If we know Lydia very well, one who worked for everybody was poor and made clothes for them, knit to their hand. That when she died, the people them bowed and said, what we are going to know regarding Lydia is dead. Her shoes will be hard to fit. We have a new mission director that was elected 2 weeks ago. And she and I have been talking over the past few days, and I know she's worried because she'll be wondering at them. And she's wondering if she'd be able to measure up to that. And I'm saying to her, don't look at what that you did, try and do what you can do. So I'll be talking to her and wanting to put some things in place because she's nervous that she won't be able to do as many. To the family, especially you, Sister Norma, mother to this wonderful woman. Board of management that they said is not holding it. We share your grief. We share your grief, we share your loss. We pray that God will give you the grace and strength to go through this difficult time. We assure you of our prayerful support, and don't forget, we know you'll come back and look for you again. Alright? And I look forward to hug you and try to comfort you in all the way I can. And I know that Bishop look forward to that, and the sister Bishop is your pastor, so not to trouble, he's always there. And so I say, in her soul, rest in peace, and the light of God for threat to shine upon her.
Thank you.
Minister on behalf of Reverend Charlie. I'm sure you will want to stand. You have been sitting for quite a while. So we are going to pause to take the offering at this time. I'm going to ask us to just stand to change the place, and I'm going to invite the ushers to come as we do this hymn. It's at the back of your program, Keep on the Fairy Line. Ladies and gentlemen, as you have heard, the passion of Sister Nadine was for missions. And she had indicated to us before her passing that if she should pass, we should collect an offering for the missions department of Clifton.
Fire in the fire. Keep on the fire in the fire.
hands and ask God's blessings on the offering collected. All good gifts around us are sent from heaven above. Lord, your people have stretched back to give to you a portion of what you blessed us with. As this offering is lifted, Lord, we ask your blessings on it. We give it back to you, Lord, to be used for your kingdom, dedicated to missions and the missions department in Clifton. May you multiply, Lord, and may these resources lead to the advancement of your kingdom as they're used to spread your gospel message. May souls be won for your kingdom. We ask in Jesus' name. Each person who stretched their hands to give, Lord, we ask a blessing on them. Those who had not to give, remember them likewise. And Lord, we give you thanks for all that you have given to us. Receive them now from our hands. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, we ask. Amen. Thank you much. Be seated, everybody. We continue with the tributes. I'm going to be calling the family members to come next to their tribute. That will be followed by Reverend G. Cunningham, pastor of the Great Valley Assemblies of Holiness Church. Then right after, the Patty Hill Assemblies of Holiness will come. And after the Patty Hill Assemblies of Holiness, we'll take a selection from Cleveland Street, brother of the deceased, in that order.
Greetings, everyone. I stand here to represent the family, myself and my daughters, just to encourage your hearts in this time of grief.
Father,
cheer up my mind.
Streete. She was a friend of mine, and she always encouraged me to live for God and be strengthened. Amen. And I do appreciate all the words of encouragement that she gave to me. I'm hoping to see her one of these days. Amen. In the dawn of the midnight, as I hold in my faith, while the storm holds around me, I make no hiding place. In the heart of the thunder,
pastor who have just sung the majority of choir, and we, the brethren from the Patty Hill Assemblies of Holiness Church, want to extend our condolence to all the family members. The God of our comfort will continue to strengthen you. I've never lived in a mansion.
little boy came to me once and said, Mrs. Sarah, we're the workforce. I was kind of taken aback, you know. I said, what do you mean by Mrs. Sarah? And he said, sir, so where are the workforce? He said, you know. And after trying to figure out what he was trying to say, he wanted to know where was he going with this conversation. And I think I frustrated him. And he said, Mr. Sir, and sir, where do you live for? He said, we don't know. So I decided to ask him. I said, what are you living for? He turned to me and said, but sir, if you saw all of you don't know, how many know? That question really struck me, and for a while I thought about it. And if I were to answer him no, I would have said to him, between life and death, between the day when you're born and when you're going to die, what is it going to be that time? It's your choice. And of course, choices are going to be dependent on your circumstances and experiences. So that's a very, very difficult question to answer. That was what I would say to him. No. Nadine, you're a great day to miss. I just want to say this on behalf of the family. Every night in my dreams, I see you, I feel you. That is how I know you. Oh my, far across the distance, there's places between us. You have come to show me, come on.
From the Lord through his servant.
Amen.
our Assistant Bishop and Conference Overseer, Pastor of the Lucy St. Simon and Clifton Circuit of Churches and the Assemblies of Holiness, Reverend Gary McHale, who are coming to bring the Word of God to us. I ask that we be quiet and reverent as we have been up to this point. We minimize the distractions as much as possible so that nothing will hinder us from hearing what the Lord would want to say to us today. Before he comes, I'm going to invite the combined choir of Lucy and Clifton Assemblies of Holiness to minister in song. And right after that, Reverend Gary McHale will be coming.
Yeah. even somewhere, just wave your hands and give God a praise. Hallelujah. It is indeed a good day to praise the Lord. And I want to acknowledge the presence of our presiding bishop once again, Reverend Hundley Webster, Bishop Emeritus Reverend Robert Roach, our General Secretary Reverend Noel Murray, our Moderator Minister Rosa Greenian, other members of the clergy on the platform and in the audience, once again, greetings. I want to especially acknowledge the presence of the bereaved family. And on behalf of my immediate family and church family and the Western Conference, of which I give oversight, I want to express condolences to the family at this time. And I know the God of comfort will continue to embrace you in this time of grief. I notice that the time is slipping very rapidly. And so I just want to endorse all the wonderful things that have been said already about our dear sister. I believe the Lord sent her to assemblies of holiness at the right time. And her contribution through the landscape of assemblies of holiness, be it local, regional, and national, has not gone unnoticed. And so we lift our caps to our beloved sister today, and we hope to meet her again. To think about the passing of our sister is to face the reality of the many voids which she has created within her family, the national church, the regional church, the local church, and certainly the community of Clifton. It is my belief that she would be much desirous of me to share then a word of comfort today. And as such, I want to draw your attention, if you are so able, to the Gospel of John the Beloved, according to chapter 14 and verse 27 through to 30, but I'll just read verse 27. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, I give unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for today and this very opportunity, Lord, we have to hear from you. We ask, Lord, that you will speak to us as we be obedient to you. We pray that you will add your richest blessings to your words. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Permit me to specially recognize the host pastor of this church, Reverend Geraldine Cunningham, who sung so beautifully earlier. I want to use this opportunity just to commend her and the membership of this church for the hard work that they have been putting in the ministry here at Great Family. As such, that today we could hold such a gathering, I want to applaud her and her membership. May the Lord bless her as she continues to serve. The book of John presents Jesus as the ideal for every life's circumstances. Jesus discourses with his disciples in this passage. He relates the imagery of the handing down of family legacy. The passing of Hebrew or Jewish parents was always a crucial period. In ancient Hebrew, the family inheritance was very important. And to some extent, today, we can relate to this very said practice. So when Jesus informed the disciples of his death, they were sad. They were disappointed and they were hopeless. But as Jesus recognized the despair and the despondency, he hastened to offer the legacy of peace. A legacy that is wholesome to life. It embodies comfort, security, strength of character, and of course, hope in the most turbulent time. The legacy of peace. This was what Jesus passed on to the disciples. And so he did this by making three statements and one command, of which we will carefully analyze in brief. He had the most needed legacy at the time of his departure. And can I say to us today that this legacy did not stop with the disciples? Amen. But it is extended to the Streete family today. It is extended to the church family today. And all those lives whom Nadine would have touched, the legacy of peace can be your portion.
even in this time of great need. So my brothers and sisters, the text says, my peace I leave with you. And this conveys the idea of the eminence of his peace. The eminence of his peace. What do I mean by the eminence of his peace? The eminence. The eminence. So Ezekiel in chapter 16 and 17 qualified the term to be associated with fame. Fame. Respected. And simply put, important. It refers literally to physical elevation. In fact, the Hebrew word, which is talul, carries the meaning of uplifted or heaped up. Brothers and sisters, the caliber of this piece was far more important to the disciples than anything else that could be considered as a legacy. The legacy of peace. It was more important than money. It was more important than land. Amen. It was more important than estate. Praise God. The peace is won when in the midst of turmoil and chaos and confusion, it reassures. It brings about certainty and hope in this time of loss. Hallelujah. Amen. The street family and church family can rest assured that there is hope beyond today. Hallelujah. Because of the legacy of peace. I submit to you, brothers and sisters, that if it is one legacy that you want today, hallelujah, when there's so much confusion, when there's so much chaos, and may I say in the world as much as in the church, there's so much confusion and chaos, and even in the family, but when you hold on to that peace, reassures you and it gives you hope.
Yes.
I want us to understand that the disciples, they were about to lose, amen, their Lord, their Rabbi, their Master. Praise God. Amen. And there are myriad of things that Jesus would have considered, amen, to give to his disciples. But he took out this one thing that was prominent. Hallelujah. And he said, hey, I give you my peace. Today I'm happy that Sister Nadine knew that. Amen. Before she closed her eyes. Amen. But the word of God said he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. That's the peace he gives, hallelujah, to the disciples. That's the peace he gives to us today, brothers and sisters. And so Isaiah 53 and verse 5, in this messianic prophecy, he's saying that Christ suffering
the anxieties that we have, the fears, the angers, yes, the insecurities today, we can apply this peace to our situation. It still stands out, hallelujah. It is still prominent, praise God, hallelujah. And so, brothers and sisters, as Jesus, amen, he passed it on, amen, to the disciples, I want us to understand that because it's not hand to hand, when something is transported or transmitted from one hand to the next, amen, it is exposed to all kinds of dangers and disadvantages. Are you viewing this, somebody? Amen. When you have to pass on something, amen, from generation to generation, from someone else to the next person and to the other person, it undergoes much compromise by the time it reaches you. Are you hearing me, somebody? When some legacy reach us, it is watered down. When some legacy reach us, it have no use. Am I talking to you, somebody?
Yeah. Thank you.
is going to be read. I know thank you. All right, the family tribute. The family tribute is still on. Have I told you? No? Yes? So we'll take that, and then I'm going to ask Rev. Parkins immediately after, Reverend Pauline Parkins, a dear friend of Sister Nadine, to do the prayer for the bereaved family. Right after that, Dr. George and Bertram Lewis and Cousin will come to move the note of thanks. So that's Everton Wood, followed by Riff Parkins, followed by Dr. Bertram Lewis, in that order.
Hello, everybody. Pleasant good afternoon to you all. I came today with that fixed assurance that it is well with Nadine's soul. My niece, and a very good friend as well of mine, for the past, I would say 3 to 4 years, we have shared a very special time together through her journey. So, in agreement with the family and of course everyone else, it was my intention to come and celebrate Nadine. Now, I will not look at her as in the past, because she's still here with us. As I mentioned, that reminds me of the story in St. John chapter 11 where Jesus was speaking to his disciples, and he informed them that his dear friend Lazarus had passed away. In fact, initially he told them that Lazarus was asleep. And then later on he told them, well, I'll be coming to see Lazarus. And his disciples, his followers said to them, but Master, if he is sleeping, don't wake him, let him be. And I think Nadine today is just sleeping. And I mentioned in the past 3 to 4 years I've had quite a deep discourse with her regarding the issues that she was facing. In fact, being a member of the medical community, she has shared in deep, deep ways what she was actually going through during that time. Now, sometimes she would have certain tests to do, or they would find certain things, and she would say, Uncle, what do you think about this? Or she would just text me, email me these results, that advice, you know, tell her what the process would be, and we'd go through all of that. So we really got really bonded during that time, during her illness. So I traveled with her. I recall even way back being in Florida when she was there at Jackson Memorial. She was taking some time with her aunt, Hope, there with her. I recall my wife and myself would travel from Fort Lauderdale down to Jackson Memorial in Miami to see her almost on a daily basis. And she went through those struggles of illness. But the thing that really got to me more than anything else, I remember that particular night, the caller said, if you want to come and see Nadine, you better come tonight because we don't think she's going to make it through the rest of this night. So my wife and I got packed up and we drove down. It was a long journey. A very long journey. And I know that she's a very, very strong girl. And that's why I believe that this piece that the pastor spoke about earlier is that she actually possessed that. And that's the legacy that Jesus left with us. But she also, Nadine, left her legacy as well. I would say that she was a fighter. Seeing her from that time in Jackson, and she went back to Jamaica. And over the years, we have made contact, not as often, but I know she's suffered and she struggled through. and she's a very, very ambitious girl as well. There's nothing that you put before her that she doesn't think she could accomplish. And I won't be redundant, but I tried to pass by some of those things that was mentioned earlier. But she was just a fighter as well. The way she was living, it did not appear as though she would not be continuing those activities today, even in the very face of illness, severe complications. So, with that said, I just want us as family to remember that. But there's some other special moments I would like to make mention of. One thing we have in common was that she was the last of her parents, and also being the last of my parents. So we share that in common. I recall at some point there's a story where her bigger sister, Myrette, they were at a certain location and down. As a young kid, Nadine was playing with her friend and somehow she decided it's about time to stop this thing, so she stopped. And the friend wanted to continue with that playing thing, so the friend was not too enthused about that, so they didn't say, I'm finished, I'm done. And the friend decided, you know what? I still want to play. Nadine said, Miss Emmy, now play! And so the girl got her by, wanted to fight her. And big sister Mary jumped on her. And I feel the way that's the way Nadine was herself. She was a real fighter, not physically, but in terms of her ambitions, in terms of the things that she wants to get done. That's how she was. She's very tenacious about getting things done. That's the way she was. Very persistent. And up to this point, to the end of this journey here on Earth, she fought to the very end. I love her dearly. I miss her not being here. He said, Uncle, what do you think about this? I remember the story where, a little earlier, when she graduated from school, her mom was living with her mom, so she said, you know, I don't want to buy a car. And her mom said, when do you have a car? Can you live in a car? And that was her ambition. She wanted to just acquire and achieve, and that's the way she was. You know, being in Kingston, she was asking her brother sometimes, Errol, can I get money? But Errol said, well, what are you doing with it? And she would persist, but not how Errol would give her those money. And that's the thing that Nadine would not give up on. She just wants what she wants. And nothing is going to stop her. So again, I came here today knowing that that's a sweet, saved soul. And that's why I'm confident. That's why I am convicted that one day, I will see her again. And if you want to see her again, you have to also make a decision to follow Christ as she did. So in ending, I want to say this, that the legacies that she left, which I am challenged by as well, consider those as very vital, very important. Those were the attributes that got her through her illness of these years. And in your life's troubles, if you want to get through some of these challenges that you face, consider being a fighter. Consider, is it okay to be ambitious? And yes, it is. Be persistent. Be tenacious about it as well. And this is a legacy, part of, that Nadine leads with us. Thank you so much. Thank you, and God bless.
My colleague, ministers on the platform, other ministers in the congregation, brothers and sisters, I greet you well. Mine is a task this evening to pray the prayer for the family. But it would have been remiss if I did not let you all know that Nadine was more than a friend to me. She was my sister from another mother. She was my secretary. She reminded me of all my appointments. She checked on me every day. But I'm not here to talk about all of that now. I just want to let you know that Nadine loves her mother to the world and back. So 2 weeks before her passing, I accompanied her to the doctor, and after coming back, she had some symptoms that I believe warrant for her to go to the emergency room. And I said, Nadine, go to the emergency room. And she said, Rev, so when you're gone, who take care of mommy? I said, when you reach that bridge, we cross it. Nadine, go to the emergency room. No, Rev, they can't leave mommy. That is how badly she loves her mother. One other thing that you need to know about Nadine is that when she's going through pain, she just needs somebody to talk to. And all her pain will disappear. So Sister Norma can attest to the fact that 2-3 o'clock at night, I will be on the phone with Nadine, just talking to her through her pain. Sister Norma said, Rev, oh yeah, Lord, Nadine, to keep you up like that. But I know she's in pain and she just needs somebody to talk to. I spoke to her the 4th of January. And she said, Rev, this low call for emergency, but I don't get there yet. Later on in the afternoon, she called me and she said, Rev, I am gone. I pretend I didn't hear her, and then said, what are you saying? And she hung up the phone. I call her back, she didn't answer. I text her, she didn't respond. That was her last word to me. And I felt in my spirit that Nadine was saying the words of this song. Going home, I am going home. There's nothing to hold me now. I've got a glimpse of the heavenly home. Praise God, I am going home. Nadine was not surprised that she was on her heavenly journey. Let us pray. Sovereign God, we acknowledge you this evening as our peace. We acknowledge you, God, as our comforter, the one who has touched with the feelings of our infant. Mighty God, all of us today have been touched by the life of Nadine Streete. And because of that, all of us are cuddling together right now, thanking you, God, for your peace. All of us in this congregation today, Lord, is like a family. Nadine was in the center of most of us lives. And that's why today, Lord, I don't even distinguish the family members from the rest of the audience. Because all of us today are grieving the passing of this great one of God. Mighty God, I ask you to undergird every family member with your grace, with your strength. I ask you, mighty God, to be very close, be very near, be very close, be very near to each and every one of this family member. Even in the face of
that there's a bigger family that I represent today.
Hallelujah!
There's a bigger family that will cushion the pain. Lord, we are not afraid to cry because tears is a language that you understand. And so, God, I pray that you will comfort us all today. Thank you, Lord, for the journey. It was hard and rugged, but God, through it all, you have kept her. Oh, God, and that is why she was not afraid to lay all down for you, mighty God. Thank you, Father. We salute you this evening, mighty God. We shout you. We go. To worship and to serve you, all out. Mighty God, we thank you for Sister Nadine's life. We thank you for his family. And we give you the praise.
Oh, yes.
And we give you the glory. And we give you the honor.
Alone. It's all a part of the Master's plan,
a step on the road to home. Miss me a little, but not for long. Nor with your heads bowed low, remember the love that we once shared. Miss me, but let me go. But remember my songs now and then. Hear the tunes that set me free. And have a glass. Close your eyes, my beloved. Know I'll be what you need. Miss me a little, but not for long. Not with your head bent low. Remember the love we once shared. Miss me, but let me go. Miss me, but let me go. Nadine is in a better place, and she is at rest. We will see her again, if we are prepared to stand the test. The world changes from year to year, or life changes from day to day. But the love and memory of you, shall never pass away. At this time, I would like to recognize every person that has made this celebration what it has been so far today. I begin by thanking God for all good gifts around us. It is because of Him why we, or I, can stand here today to say thanks. To the House of Eden, we thank you for a job well done. For the flower arrangement which you can see from Nadine's very good friend, very beautiful, done by her friend. We thank all those who tirelessly prepare the grave where precious will be laid to rest. We say a massive thank you to the pastor of Clifton Church, Assemblies of Holiness, for your input and notice and assistance to this celebration. Our thanks goes to you as a pastor and to the church that Lydia speaks so warmly and affectionately. Thank you. As mentioned, Nurse Lorna, we know that your friendship went beyond just worshiping together, and we thank you. Preparation of this building, Desi, wherever you have done an amazing job getting the sanctuary ready for us to decorate during your time of preparation. Many favors was asked of you, and you never said no. Instead, you said, she was one of us. It has to be done. I will do it. That is okay. We do not have the words to thank you enough. God bless you and all those who work tirelessly with you. To the ladies who helped us on Thursday, God bless you all. Pastor Cunningham, may God continue to cover you in His grace. Thank you for giving us the use of His sanctuary without restrictions. You allowed us to do all of this. To everyone who has traveled from near and far to attend the celebration, let me just say, actions speak louder than words. Thank you, and I pray for journey mercies as you make your return journey home to your respective homes. God bless you. For all your tributes and kind words, thank you. For your surprise, for the surprise that awaits you, we thank you for your contribution. My daughter, who worked and traveled and supported me in every way, thank you, Roxanne. God bless you. The construction of the tent, bringing the chairs, super wherever you are, super and crew, we thank you for everything. We live in a world that seems to strive on money, the need for money for everything you do or need to do. It is not always a good feeling. So I thank you all for all the contributions, love, and gifts. To God be the glory. Family, we do not need thanks, but it is polite to say it. We come together in unity and one accord to ensure we celebrate our dear Nadine in a way that she would have done had it been otherwise. This is just a picture of who she was and the things she did in her lifetime. I know she's not sitting among us today, but this is a reminder of who she was. And this memory will remain in our hearts for years to come. And dare I say, forever,
All this was done in her honor. Thank you, family, for the unity and love displayed and for your individual and collective support and effort in saying goodbye to a life that was affected by challenges and sickness, but nevertheless well-lived. Auntie Norma, for all those who visited you, spent time with you, share with you, console and love you, we say thanks. And do remember, God will not give you more than you can bear. When someone you love becomes a memory, the memory becomes a treasure. Family, friends, loved ones, all who impacted your life in one way or another, thank you and God bless you. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Lewis. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of this part of the celebration today. I want to thank you for being a good audience and for being very cooperative and orderly. It was my pleasure serving you today. We leave from here and we move on to the Presbyterian Church Cemetery in Ponce, Hannibal, for the interment. As it relates to recession, I'm going to ask you all to remain in your places. The platform party will lead off first, followed by the casket and the family members, and then the rest of you. So we're going to be singing our recessional hymn, and at the start of the second stanza, I'm going to ask the platform party to lead off.
Thank you.
right, so we are here, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, for the continuation of the service of Thanksgiving for Nadine. We are going to have a prayer and the committal, and then we are going to sing for the rest of the afternoon. Okay.
Nadine!
All right.
Hold on.
Do you think I...
Yes, right here.
Goodbye, my girl.
All right, come.
Oh, she give it. She give already. She give it already.
Let us pray. Our eternal God.
Quiet, please.
Eternal God, our creator. You are the preserver of all mankind, the giver of all spiritual grace and the author of everlasting life. We give you thanks again for the life of Nadine. We give thanks for the life she lived and for what she has meant to family and friends. We give thanks for the love of God and for the salvation which is he has so freely offered to us, not on our own merit, but on the merit of his son Jesus Christ.
Yes.
For whosoever believeth in him should not perish,
hey,
but shall have
everlasting
life.
Talk to me.
Lord, we pray that you'll send your holy angels to mark this very spot, so that when the trump shall have sounded, she too shall rise to meet you. We pray a blessing upon the rest of this evening's proceeding. And we give a praise, honor, and glory, and tell a thanks in Jesus' name.
Nothing wrong with that.
Amen, amen.
Wait.
I declare to you, brothers,
yes,
that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God.
Yes.
Nor doth the perishable inherit the imperishable. Listen, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep.
Yes.
But we will all be changed.
Yes.
In a flash.
Yes.
In the twinkling of an eye. At the last trump.
Yes.
For the trump will sound.
Yes.
The dead will raise imperishable. And we will be changed.
Yes.
For the perishable.
Yes.
Must clothe itself with imperishable.
Yes.
And the mortal with immortality.
Yes.
When the perishable has been clothed with the imperishable and the mortal with immortality,
yes,
then the saying that is written will come through.
That goes to me, you know,
death has been swallowed up in victory.
Yes.
Where, O death,
yes,
is your victory.
Yes.
Where, O death, is your sting.
Talk to me.
The sting of death is sin.
Speak it out.
And the power of sin is the law.
Lord.
But thanks be to God.
Talk to me.
He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Therefore, my beloved, my dear brothers, stand firm.
Yes.
Let nothing move you.
Yes.
Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord.
Yes.
Because you know that your labor
far as much
in the Lord is not in vain.
You come down.
For as much as please Almighty God,
yes,
in his wise providence,
God told me now
to take out of this world
that no one here
the soul of our departed loved one. God. We therefore commit our body to the ground.
Earth
to earth. Ashes to ashes. Dust to dust. Looking for that general resurrection in the last day.
Yes.
And the life of the world to come.
Give me this.
Through
me
our Lord Jesus Christ.
Hold on. Come over.
In glorious majesty, earth and the sea shall give up their bones. And the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him will be changed and made alive.
Put in there. Put inside there.
One of them. Please turn to your program. As we do the hymn, I'll meet you in the morning by the bright river side. Somebody read. Come on.
Let's go.